In this video, I'm going to talk about how to find the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons in both neutral atoms and in ions, which are atoms that have a charge. Okay, so if we start with nitrogen on our grid, the first thing we do with all of these is to find that element on the periodic table. So if we look at this, we can find nitrogen towards the top right here. And if we were to zoom in on just the square of nitrogen on the periodic table, we'd see something like this. And so we usually have these four pieces of information, and our number on top, that's our atomic number. And the atomic number is equal to the number of protons. So this answers our first question. Nitrogen has 7 protons. And nitrogen will always have 7 protons. This is the one number that never changes. It always is going to be until the end of time that every nitrogen has 7 protons. That's the definition of nitrogen. So it's like kind of like the social security number of an element is the atomic number. All right, so next we're asked, how many neutrons does nitrogen have? And for this, we're actually going to have to put a question mark because we aren't given enough information in this problem to know what this particular nitrogen atom has. And not every single nitrogen atom has the same number of neutrons. So that's based on something called the mass number that we'll get to a little bit. Based on the periodic table, the only information about the mass of this nitrogen is just the general atomic mass, which is our number on the bottom. It's a decimal point. And the atomic mass is just the average mass of that element. So it doesn't really help us tell how heavy this particular nitrogen atom is, so we can't figure out how many neutrons it exactly has. All right, so next we have the number of total electrons. And so for this, we'll have to learn this piece of information, which is that a neutral atom has the same number of electrons as it does protons, which is the same as the atomic number. So if you aren't told anything about an atom's charge, you can assume it's neutral. And so in this case, it means that our nitrogen is just going to have 7 electrons because it's the same number as our atomic number. All right. And so then lastly, we have to do the number of valence electrons, which is just the number of electrons on that last orbital that has any electrons in it. And so for this, we're going to use our overall trend. And so the trend is that starting on the left-hand column of the periodic table, everything in this column has 1 valence electron. And then the second column has 2 valence electrons. So everything in the second column has 2 valence electrons. And then getting to these transition metals, these you cannot predict with these trends. Nothing in here you can just look at and know exactly how many valence electrons you have. And then by the time we get over to this third column, this has 3 valence electrons, and we just fill this in until we get to the end. All right, so now we can just, using our trends, see that nitrogen is in the 5th column, so it's going to have 5 valence electrons. And so everything in this column would also have 5 valence electrons. All right, let's now go to an element that's written a little bit differently. So we have sodium and then a dash and then the number 20. Okay, so first of all, we can always find the number of protons just by identifying this element on the periodic table. So we look for sodium, that's abbreviated Na. We find it right here on the left-hand side. And so sodium is number 11. So atomic number, that's always your number of protons. So sodium will always have 11 protons. And now we can actually find the number of neutrons. So if we bring this problem over to our bottom right here, we can identify this number. So when elements are written like this, the full element name, dash, then a number, that's actually talking about the mass number. And so the mass number is the number of neutrons plus the number of protons, because those are the two particles that make up the huge, huge, huge majority of a mass of any atom. Okay, so if we want to find the number of neutrons, then all we have to do is to subtract the mass number minus the atomic number, which is the number of protons, and that will give us our number of neutrons. Okay, so to plug this into this formula, remembering that whenever we see something with that dash, that means the mass number. So now this is also talking about just this sodium atom, not sodium atoms in general. So for just this sodium atom, it has a mass number of 20. And then we're going to subtract the atomic number, so 11. And so we're going to get 9. And so this particular sodium atom has 9 neutrons. Okay, so now let's find the number of total electrons. So again, we weren't given any information about the charge, so we're going to assume it's neutral. So that means that it has the same number of electrons as it does protons, so 11. And now to find the number of valence electrons, so sodium is in our first column right here, and so everything in that column only has 1 valence electron. All right, so now going to our next example, this has a lot of stuff going on, and it's written a little bit differently than our other examples, so let's bring it down to the bottom right and define it. So when you have anything written like this, the number to the top left, that's just the mass number once again. And the number on the bottom left, that's just the atomic number, which we can double check by looking up selenium on the periodic table, and it's right here, number 34. And then we have our atomic symbol, SE, and then our number to the top right, that's our charge. And so charge is just the number of protons minus the number of electrons. All right, so with all that information, let's start going through and seeing how many particles we have of each one. So number of protons, that's the easiest. It's just going to be that atomic number, 34. Number of neutrons, again, we have to subtract from the mass number. So we're going to have 70 minus 34. So we get a total of 36. Total number of electrons. Now this is the first one where we do have information about the charge. So our charge is negative 2, which means you have 2 more electrons than you do protons. So we have 34 protons, and so each electron is negative. So if we have 2 negative, we have 2 more electrons than we do protons. So this is going to mean that we have 36 electrons. And now to find the number of valence electrons, well, we can find how many valence electrons a neutral selenium has just by looking at the periodic table, and we see it's in that 6th column over here. So that means that normally it has 6 valence electrons, but remember our selenium has a charge of negative 2, which means it has an additional 2 electrons. So this guy has a number of 8 valence electrons. All right, let's go and do an example similar to that. So we have our next symbol, and so once again, number of protons, that's the easiest. This is just going to be our bottom left number, 8. Also, on the periodic table, oxygen number 8, so 8 protons. And so number of neutrons, 17, the mass number for this particular oxygen atom, minus 8 equals 9. This particular oxygen has 9 neutrons. So now the total number of electrons, there is no charge indicated, which means we're going to assume it's neutral. And so we just look to the periodic table, and it has 8 protons, which means if it's neutral, it's going to have 8 electrons. And so now the number of valence electrons, we can, again, just look at the periodic table, and we see that oxygen, just like selenium was, is in that 6th column, so it's going to have 6 valence electrons. All right, a few different wordings. Now we have carbon-13, and we're just told this has a charge of negative 3. So first of all, look up carbon on the periodic table. It's right here. Number 6, so it has 6 protons. Number of neutrons, 13 minus 6, so that's a total of 7 neutrons. And then we have, for total number of electrons, we know that normally, if it was neutral, it would have 6 electrons to cancel out all those protons, and we know that this has a charge of negative 3, so it must have an additional 3 electrons, so this guy has 9 total electrons. All right, and then the number of valence electrons. So normally carbon is in that 4th column, so normally it has 4 valence, and we know that this has an extra 3 electrons, so we have 4 plus 3, so this carbon has 7 valence electrons. All right, so now we have silver-87, so looking up silver, it's down here, number 47, so it has 47 protons. And then for number of neutrons, we do have our dash and then the number. And remember, that equals our mass number. So we have 87 minus 47. So we have a total of 40 neutrons. And so now to get our number of total electrons, we are just going to assume it's neutral because we're not told anything about the charge. So that means that it has the same number of protons and electrons. so 47. And now for number of valence electrons, we're going to have to put a question mark, because remember, this is in our area where we cannot predict how many valence. So we have no idea how many are going to be in any of these elements. It can really vary. That's why you can't predict it. Okay, so now our last example, we have number of protons going to be 8. That's our atomic number. Number of neutrons, 16 minus 8. And now we're just told this has 3 valence electrons. So let's look to where oxygen is now. It's over here at 8. And so filling in 3 valence electrons, now how are we going to get our number of total electrons? All right, well, we know that oxygen usually has 8 electrons, and we know it only has 3 valence electrons. The question is, how many valence electrons does it normally have, and then what's the difference? And so it's in that 6th column. So normally it has 6 valence electrons. So if it only has 3, it basically has 3 less electrons than it normally does. So then overall, it has 8 electrons normally, so minus 3. Overall, now it just has 5 electrons, and only 3 are valence. All right, I hope you guys learned how to find some particles and different strategies. I hope some are useful, and have a good studying.